I had recognized that nothing happens unless somebody's not satisfied with the status quo. And I believe that to this day, that becoming comfortable is a recipe for no progress at all. And so I'm actually always looking for people who are just slightly unhappy. I learned that I wasn't really the world's greatest mathematician. I took classes in Riemannian geometry and sort of broke my pick on that, and realized that computers were more interesting because you could create this artificial world that you were in control of, and it did what you told it to do. Sometimes it did not what you wanted it to do, but what you told it to do, and the difference between those is called a bug. You begin to see how powerful this could be. Think of all the different kinds of computers that were part of the dozen
right.
that are now interacting with each other. They never would have before because they were made by different manufacturers or different brands. They have different word lengths. They have all these technical differences. The network is making it possible for them to interact. But there wasn't anything more rich than exploring this interactive capability of working together as a group. The question now is, given these very distinct networks, how on earth would we connect them all together in a uniform way? Over a couple of days, Bob and I sat down and wrote the first paper that was published the following year describing the internet. It's important to notice this is not purely an American invention.
Right.
We had help from the Norwegians and the Germans and the French and the Italians and the Japanese. We were part of this process. Anyone who thinks this just sort of happened, or a bunch of local area networks got together one day and the internet happened, would be wrong. This was a real battle. And it's not the only battle. We have to think about the abuses of infrastructure as we always have. The internet and many things like it are neutral. They're tools that can be used and abused. And we often mistakenly imagine that we can somehow use technology to prevent abuse. And the answer is sometimes we can. And then we will have to understand whether we agree sufficiently to work together to cope with some of those abuses and to put the bad people away.